safety exists in Greece today because of Mr. Arkis Passion. He traveled and trained thousands of people throughout the country.
Lukas has always been a selfless and tireless life-saving teacher. He is a man of honor whose work inspired and fueled professionally my generation.
In 1941, Greece was engaged in the Second World War. Lukas Bistorakis was born into a poor family in Daia Bayosha. At the age of 9, he learned swimming in water holes and in a trough where the goats drank water because, as a school child, he had read that an Australian lifeguard saved the life of a man who had been attacked by a shark. He dreamed that one day he would become a lifeguard. In 1965, after completing his instructor course at the aquatic school at Camp Wakanda, he proudly said to the National American Red Cross headquarters, "I will return to Greece to organize life-saving courses because we have no schools." Gloria, Gloria. Over the next 50 years, he undertook several landmarked activities that enhanced life-saving and spread the word of water safety nationwide. In 1966, the Prime Minister of Greece, Stefanos Stephanopoulos, told him, "Son, Greeks will appreciate your work on life-saving the next 100 years. Lukas established the first ever national organizations, the Panhellenic School of Lifeguarding, the Institute of Swimming and Lifeguarding, and the Scuba Life-Saving Corps of the Hellenic Red Cross. Overall, he founded 17 nationally approved life-saving scuba diving charities and organizations in all over Greece. In these organizations, Lukas trained about 35,000 students from over 30 nations. He taught camp counselors, babysitters, and persons with disabilities swimming, scuba diving, personal survival at sea, life-saving, lifeguarding, and first aid. He worked as the instructor for all instructor candidates of Red Cross in Europe, and as a volunteer teacher of the National Academy of Physical Education students in Athens. Lukas made his living as a public servant in various ministries and as an entertainer in nightclubs, so that he could teach life-saving on a voluntary basis. He organized several fundraising galas, parades, and exhibits to raise life-saving awareness. Most of these activities were endorsed and commented on by ministers and prime ministers, princes and kings, directors of governing bodies, country ambassadors, academics, famous artists, and his students in Greece and abroad. Lukas organized 15 national and 3 international scuba diving and life-saving symposia. The most noted ones were the Panhellenic Conference in Macedonia of Greece that was endorsed by the Minister of Culture, Melina Mercouri, and the World Water Safety Conference that took place in Skiathos Island. He represented Greece in both European and international meetings and organizations. Throughout his career, Bistorakis performed dozens of aquatic rescue interventions as a lifeguard. He established the first 2 legislations for pool and beach lifeguarding and published the first lifeguard booklet. Bistorakis envisioned that one day Greece would be able to organize national life-saving sporting championships to prepare students academically to be teachers and lifeguards, to develop water safety awareness, and to maintain 1 volunteer lifeguard at every beach and pool in the country. He also dreamed that all children would take free swimming lessons the last school week before the annual summer holidays. During his career, Mr. Rakis has received 18 awards in 9 countries for his contributions to water safety. In 1981, he visited U.S. President Ronald Reagan in the White House to present him with an award for his 77 lifeguard rescues. However, because of the president's busy schedule, he unselfishly did not ask to be photographed with him. Ronald Reagan was informed about that, came out of his office, and with a warm handshake, he said, "Thank you very much. You are a real man." Lucas became an honorary resident of Nashville, Tennessee, in the U.S., an honorary member of the Hellenic Red Cross, and got the award for lifetime achievements from the National School of Public Health and the Hellenic Federation of Scuba Diving and Sport Fishing. Despite his recognition, Bistorakis was severely criticized by his opponents for his work and was sent to court over 200 times. He fought for his rights to teach life-saving voluntarily and to report incompetence and corruption. The court always declared him innocent.
Lucas created several enemies who tried to stop his activity. Now, after 50 years, they all recognize his work in life-saving and scuba diving.
Lucas Bistorakis is a fine example of a pioneer who contributed to society, but who also suffered severely. For over 50 years, Lucas's activities were favorably commented on and endorsed by several people in Greece and abroad.
Each aquatic safety professional of my generation can take pride, maybe, for 2 to 3 personal achievements. Lucas, during his life, did almost everything.
Today, at 71 years of age, he continues to plan how to enhance water safety in Greece like a modern Don Quixote. Several decades ago, at the end of an inspirational speech, Lucas was applauded when he said,
"All I did in my life was not for me, but for the others and the joy of creation."